I'm going to start this out with this line element here. This is an exact solution to Einstein's field equations for the stress energy tensor written below, which represents colliding electromagnetic waves. This is a solution that I worked out quite some time ago, but this solution has an event horizon where the stuff inside the radical goes to zero. And I thought that I might be able to find some other interesting solutions that would be related by looking at non-singular coordinates. So I was looking for a related solution in terms of non-singular coordinates, that is coordinates that don't have an event horizon. And I found that this line element here exactly has a zero Ricci scalar. And what that means is that the fields for the matter that contribute to the stress energy tensor that yield this line element are mediated by massless particles. So basically I'm looking from this for electromagnetic radiation solutions and gravitational wave solutions. Well, I found something interesting in terms of a gravitational wave solution that comes from this. This next line element is a case of that previous line element. And here I'll point out that F and G have units of acceleration, and A is a unitless parameter. The software that I have converting this to a movie file doesn't show the smaller letters really well, so I'll point out that that little thing above the C's and the fractions is a 2. That's a C squared that's there, and also the stuff inside the radical is 1/4 plus A minus A squared. So this line element is an exact vacuum solution to Einstein's field equations. This stress energy tensor is exactly zero for this line element. Now, for this line element, as long as F is not equal to minus G and A is not equal to 0 or 1, the space-time curvature is not 0 for this line element. That means that this is not a trivial solution to Einstein's field equations. It is not a mere frame transformation from the metric of special relativity. So the waves in this vacuum solution, in the metric here, are descriptive of gravitational wave forms that are traveling in it. Now, the reason that I'm making this video, what I found that was interesting about this solution, is that the wave forms that are perturbances in the metric coefficients of the dx squared and dy squared terms travel at the speed of light at c, but the waveform that is the perturbance in the metric on the dct squared term and dz squared term, that one travels at the speed g over f. It doesn't travel at the speed c. And that wouldn't be interesting if null geodesics for the z direction were also moving at the speed g over f. But the null geodesics moving in the z direction for this line element are moving at the speed c. And yet the gravitational perturbance describing the waveform here is traveling at the speed g over f, which can hypothetically be anything. This is interesting. This is, I think, analogous to what happens when you have electromagnetic waves traveling in the vacuum region inside a conductive waveguide. Inside a waveguide, electromagnetic waves do not travel at the speed of light. They have a phase wave that can be essentially anything. The group speed for electromagnetic waves inside waveguides is limited to the speed of light, unless you have some very peculiar quantum effects that you're considering. The group speed is limited to that, and the phase speed can be essentially anything. And I think that this is kind of the same phenomenon. This is a vacuum solution, And the waveforms that comprise this solution must have superimposed in a nonlinear way. Einstein's field equations are extremely nonlinear, in such a way that the speed of the gravitational wave perturbing the metric coefficients on the dct squared term and the dz squared term, that speed is g over f and can be essentially anything. So I thought that this was an interesting exact vacuum solution for gravitational waves, and I thought I would share that. Quadrata demonstrata.